There they were, Jimmy and the Buddy Meister, lost in the depths of YouTube movie reviews.
God damn it, Buddy!
Once again, like so many times before, Jimmy Cage blamed the Buddy Meister for something of which he knew nothing.
I swear, Jimmy, it wasn't me. I wasn't even here. It's not possible.
Suddenly, the Buddy Meister was uncertain. Was it me, he asked himself, or was it someone else? Don't tell me fairy tales, Jimmy said. I will beat the truth right out of you.
Buddy? Jimmy?
Servus Freunde, my name is Jimmy Cage
and I'm Dennis, the Buddy Meister.
And it's our ongoing pleasure to review one Indian movie each week. And if you want to get early information on what we're working on or vote on the next picks or choose a movie directly for us, you can now head over to our newly launched Patreon at patreon.com/thejimmycage.
Today's movie is something special and something we picked ourselves. No recommendations involved. It's the Hindi language drama Duvida, written and directed by Mani Kaul.
Duvida was released in 1973 and can be translated to something like indecision or limbo, a state in between things, if you will. This state can be applied to various characters, if not all the characters in this movie. But first and foremost, it describes the uncomfortable and unfair situation that the main character Lachi is in.
Duvida is based on a story by Rajasthan writer Vijay Dandeta that itself is related to a popular folktale from this area. It can be called a ghost story, it certainly is one, but it's not only that. The ghost in this story is used as a means to reveal injustices and social imbalances in gender equality, especially the freedom and sexuality of women.
The story reads as follows. A newlywed woman whose husband leaves for work in a faraway city encounters a ghost. The ghost falls in love with her, takes on the form of her husband and begins living with her.
What a great story! It instantly dug its way into my mind and all kinds of ideas and conceptions spread out. And although I knew that Duvida was going to be a different kind of movie, I was still surprised at how the story was realized.
Duvida was extensively shot in Borunda village in Rajasthan, where the author Vijay Dandeta was born. Director Mani Kaul utilized a mix of freeze frames and moving sequences to tell the story. The result can assuredly be called artful, aesthetic and poignant.
Yes, first of all, Duvida looks fantastic. The cinematography by Navroz Contractor is beautiful. Many scenes look exactly like still lifes. Interestingly, not only when they are shown as a freeze frame, but also when there's simply no movement in a moving picture.
And these beautiful images are also multifaceted. Not only on a visual level, meaning the colors, which are sometimes very saturated, in other cases more bleached, but also in what they evoke. They sometimes downright overboil with emotion. The facial expressions, especially through the eyes, the gestures, the slow movement, everything is composed in a way that gives you a mythic feeling.
Adding to that is, of course, the rather slow pace of the movie. It gives you time to think about everything and to really take it all in. It's a bit like if you look at a picture book very slowly, page by page. It's not boring, it's a lyrical and soulful experience that sticks with you.
Yeah, and it's not like the story is not progressing. We do not know very much about our characters, but interestingly, we know enough to have empathy. And what's probably even more interesting is that this empathy sways from one character to the other and back again.
Which again circles back to the meaning of the word duvida. We as viewers are in some kind of limbo as well, I think. But it's needless to say that the focus of the movie lies on Lachi and her unbearable situation.
Nobody asks her anything. Nobody gives her a chance of expressing something. She's the goods that people talk about. The norms of propriety are to be decided by her husband and her father-in-law.
Yes, but Duvida actually provides a much bigger target for analysis. Lachi actively chose not to wait 5 years for her husband and to instead live with a ghost that resembles him. And she, of course, knows that it is a ghost and not her husband because he told her. And after everything comes to light, she's not doomed or anything, but actually accepted. So we could see this as some kind of sign of a change in or challenge of the patriarchal system.
Maybe, but then again, this acceptance might only be possible because the ghost looked and felt like the real husband. Would it have been any other man? I don't know. The challenge itself was made, but the patriarchal confines still gained the upper hand in the end.
Clearly, yes. The basic criticism is obvious, though. At one point, the ghost says, what does marriage even mean? So this whole system, this whole structure, is examined very carefully.
But the whole construct that this movie is, again, leaves the audience in this state between things at the end, indecisive. The moral compass of Duvida is very ambiguous, and none of the figures appear to be the epitome of morality. No one is without fault.
And that's what I meant with the swaying empathy. Duvida is a small and impressive movie that I won't forget that fast, if ever.
Me neither. So what would we say in German?
Duvida ist nicht nur ein Film, Duvida ist auch ein Kunstwerk. Und das nicht nur aufgrund der technischen Spielereien, sondern auch wegen der kunstvollen Verzahnung von Geistergeschichte, Mythos, Sozial- und Geschlechterkritik. Sehr sehenswert.
I give Duvida 7 out of 10. It's more like 7.3. But I don't do that.
For me, it's also 7 out of 10. It's more like 7.4. But I don't do that either. Did you know that none other than Satyajit Ray ripped Duvida apart by saying that Money Cowell has not only done away with most of the clichés of narrative cinema, but with most of its axioms too?
Well, I guess even Ray was not without fault. So, what are your thoughts about Duvida? Have you even seen this little gem? Leave a comment. And hit me up on Twitter, Instagram and Letterboxd simply at The Jimmy Cage.
And you can hit me up on Twitter at The Bodymeister.
You can also find our newly launched Patreon account at patreon.com/TheJimmyCage to get extra content and ways to participate even more in our exploration of Indian cinema. And if you enjoyed this review, please give us a thumbs up, share, subscribe, whatever you like. And make sure you hit that bell for all we have to tell.